Good morning, Kendall Elementary School. This is Thursday, June 4th. I'm your host, Mr. King, with the morning announcements to let you know that this day in history, on June 4th, a patent for the first ATM was granted to Don Wetzel, Tom Barnes, and George Christian. That means in 1973 it was the first opportunity for people to use an ATM. And before that, you had to go to the bank teller. Speaking of banks, we'll be going back to a little bit about banks come the question and challenge of the day. But before we do that, you know the first thing we do. Please stand for the flag salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. It's time for your Kendall weather report to let you guys know that we are going to be having a warmer day today, a warmer day tomorrow, and then back to that kind of comfortably low and cool for the remainder of the weekend and into the beginning of next week. But relatively dry, relatively sunny, just really going to be great weather all around. We're going to pop up to, you know, the 78s for today and tomorrow, and then drop down to the high and then mid to low 60s through the beginning of next week and the weekend. So that just means we got some beautiful, beautiful weather coming in. To give you a little bit of a heads up, though, we're starting to approach that season where the mosquitoes are out. So if you check out, actually, the Weather Channel does track this, which is really cool. It seems to be that kind of the nearing end of the weekend, this last weekend, we had a dip in when the mosquitoes were around. We're going to do the same thing this week, probably having to do with the amount of sunlight that's going to be out and how much drier it's going to be. So, you know, watch out. They're out there. Maybe wear some bug spray every once in a while if you want to. The other big thing to watch out is tree pollen is bad right now. So if you have tree pollen allergies, definitely take that Allegra Zyrtec or Claritin, whichever is the one effective for you. The grass allergens are low and the ragweed has not yet bloomed. So it's really only the people with tree allergies got to worry about it right now. On the other part of it, I did tell you we were going to look at that tropical storm over in the Gulf of Mexico. And if you look, it really is forming. It is going to likely become a hurricane soon. But as it does, it looks like it is tracking to head towards Houston, New Orleans. Yet this is still early in its development, so this storm might very well dissipate earlier, lose strength, or we hope it doesn't gain strength, because we know that, you know, both New Orleans and Houston do not need any more hurricane action over the last couple of years. So that's the weather coming up, and I hope you guys have a great one. Hey guys, time for the question, also the challenge of the day. Remember to send your answers to my email. So as you remember, kids, the last time we talked, we had spoken about board games and their very first incarnation invention. And I bet you didn't really know board games are actually an ancient thing. Madison Holtz did. She told us that Senet was found in the pre-dynastic and first dynasty burials in Egypt. So the very beginning of the ancient Egyptians, they had board games. And 3,500 BC and 3,100 BC, respectively. The oldest board game is known to have existed with Senet, and is pictured right here in a fresco, and then was actually, this, what you see right there is the replica, the recreation of it. So, really cool. And the very first video game, was actually a very simple tennis game, but it, it wasn't actually Pong, but it was extremely similar to Pong. I saw it, the game screen that it was on wasn't even a real screen with pixels. It was actually this screen that was meant to show wavelengths, which is really kind of cool. So it was like they hacked a different kind of device to become the very first video game. So really cool stuff. Madison, way to deep dive on that. Very nice. And that leads us into this next part about one of the most iconic board games. We said it was going to have to do with banking. Yes, it is. Monopoly. We all know the Monopoly man, that greedy little dude with the mustache, who is telling us that we have to pay a luxury tax. Anyways, I'm curious about the invention of Monopoly. I would like you to find out who invented it
And actually, what was the original name? Because it was not originally a Milton Bradley game, it was actually something a little different. The challenge is for you to either draw or create physically as a sculpture a new Monopoly piece. Come on, we got like the dog, we got the iron, all these kind of boring things. I threw the merman in there myself right here. Here's my awesome sketch of what he should look like. I think he would be a great addition to the Monopoly board set. So, that's it. Hey there, stop right there. Don't pass go, don't collect your $200 just yet. First, you know what we gotta do. We gotta do the Kendall mission statement. The mission of Kendall Central School District is to provide the knowledge, skills, values, and attitudes needed by students to live responsibly and to compete successfully in today's and tomorrow's world. That means get out there, learn something, do something, be good today. Enjoy that amazing weather you're gonna have all through today and the weekend, and stay colorful, Kendall.